We welcome you all in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth to hear the voice of God and to receive blessings from the throne of grace. Let us pray together to receive the help of Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for your presence in each one of our lives. We thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for helping us to receive the love of Father in each one of our lives. We thank you, Jesus, for your Lordship in our lives. We thank you for your death and precious blood on the cross of Calvary. We thank you for the redemption and the holiness through your precious blood. We thank you for your chosen children from every country, O Father God. We thank you for helping us to hear the word of God. All the plans of Satan be broken in the name of Jesus. We love you, we bless you. In Jesus' name we agree and we pray. Amen. Shalom. We welcome you all in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Today's topic from the throne of grace. Why do we need to celebrate? We need to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ. Dear chosen children of God, we have a reason to celebrate every day. What is the reason? Reason number one is Lord Jesus gives us the victory. In the book of first book of Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 57, it is written, "Thanks be to Father who gives us the victory through Lord Jesus Christ." Lord Jesus gives us the victory in the midst of the pain, in the midst of the problems, in the midst of the sickness, in the midst of the danger, in the midst of the harm, in the midst of the problems. Lord Jesus gives us the victory because Lord Jesus won the battle on the cross of Calvary. So there is a reason for you and I to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ. Praise be to Jesus for his word, a promise in each one of our lives. Dear chosen children of God, we are not of this world to cry like the people of this world who do not have a hope in this world. You and I belong to Lord Jesus. Our citizenship is from heaven. That's what the word of God says in the book of Philippians chapter 3 verse 20. My citizenship is from heaven. Your citizenship is from heaven, dear. Chosen children of God, who are you? You are not of this world. Therefore, do not be afraid of the things of this world. Do not be afraid of the situation. Do not be afraid of the sickness. Do not be afraid of your future. Do not be afraid of the sickness. Do not be afraid of virus. Do not be afraid of the future. Rejoice in the Lord. And again, I say rejoice. In the book of Philippians chapter 4, verse 6, 7, 8 says, "Dear chosen children of God, rejoice in the Lord." And again, I say rejoice. Come to the throne of grace and celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ. There is a reason for the church to celebrate. Church, you and I have the hope in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord Jesus won the battle on the cross of Calvary. Dear chosen children of God, in this world, people are crying, people are suffering, people are dying every day. They have no hope. They do not know what's going to happen tomorrow. But dear church, you and I know what's going to happen in future. Lord Jesus is going to come again into this world, dear chosen children of God. What is going to happen in the whole world? Dear chosen children of God, these are the times. These are the things. Whatever is happening in and around the globe, what you and I need to do, remember the word of God. Remember the word of prophecies. Remember the signs of Lord Jesus Christ. In the book of Matthew chapter 24 verse 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Reveal the future things. What is going to happen today and tomorrow, dear chosen children of God. There will be pestilences, there will be plagues, there will be wars, there will be famines, there will be wars in the world. But do not be afraid of all those things, whatever is happening in the world. As a church, as a saint, and as a servant of God, who are washed by the blood of Jesus, dear chosen children of God, you and I have a reason to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus is not in the grave. Dear children of God, Mary Magdalene and many sisters, when Lord Jesus was alive on this earth, they had gone to see Lord Jesus at the tomb. In the book of Matthew chapter 28, when you see women of God had gone to the tomb to see the body of Jesus Christ. He was not there. The holy angels had spoken to Mary Magdalene and the other sisters, "Why are you looking for the risen Savior? He is not here. He is risen. Praise be to Jesus." They were afraid. There was a pain. There was a depression. There was a loneliness. in the hearts of the women who have gone to see Lord Jesus' dead body. Dear children of God, He is the risen Savior. Praise Jesus. Praise be to God for His grace upon each one of our lives. He is not in the tomb. He is not in this world. Very Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Lord Jesus, dwells in our lives. Lord Jesus is seated on the throne. He has all the authority in heaven and the earth. Dear children of God, in the book of Ephesians chapter 1, verses 20, 21 and 22, when you read, you and I shall receive the blessings, dear chosen children of God. There's a reason for us to celebrate the resurrection power of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Lord Jesus won the battle on the cross of Calvary. Lord Jesus Christ is the head of the church. You are the church, dear chosen children of God. We are washed by the blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. When you come to the throne of grace, when you say, Lord Jesus, please forgive me, I'm a sinner. Lord Jesus is just and faithful to forgive each one of our sins. Therefore, do not be afraid. Do not worry about the things, whatever is happening around the globe, dear chosen children of God. This is not the end. This is the beginning of Lord Jesus Christ soon coming. Lord Jesus is going to come again, second time. Dear chosen children of God, in this world, there is a fear. In this world, there is a sickness. In this world, there is a death. In this world, there is no peace. But in the church, in the believer's heart, in you and I, there's a peace, there is a joy, there is a hope, there is a faith. Praise be to Jesus for the revelation, for the gift of the Holy Spirit who strengthens us. Who are we? We are the chosen children of God. Praise be to Jesus. In the book of Isaiah chapter 61 verses 1 to 3. Spirit of the Lord is upon me to heal the sick, to set the captives free, to proclaim good news to the poor. Praise be to Jesus. In the book of John the Gospel chapter 1 verse 12. Anyone who believes in Jesus Christ and accepts Him as the Lord, as a personal Savior, Lord Jesus gives them the authority and the power to become like children. Praise be to God. Therefore, who are you? You are a child of God. I am a child of God. As a child of God, we need to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus. Number one reason to celebrate the victory, because Jesus won the battle on the cross of Calvary. Sickness cannot destroy you. Death in this world, problems in this world cannot destroy your spiritual life. Dear chosen children of God, in fact, what does Bible say? Satan cannot touch your spirit. Our spirits are sealed with the power of the Holy Spirit. In the book of Ephesians chapter 1 verse 13 reveals the truth to the mankind. My spirit is sealed with the power of the Holy Spirit. Demons cannot touch my spirit. World cannot touch my spirit. Sickness cannot touch my spirit. Things of this world cannot touch my spirit. Problems in this world cannot touch my spirit. Same thing with you. To every believer who believes in Jesus Christ of Nazareth, anyone who believes in the birth of Jesus, anyone who believes in the life of Jesus, anyone who believes in the blood of Jesus, anyone who believes in the death of Jesus, anyone who believes in the resurrection power of Jesus, and say to Jesus, Lord Jesus, I am a sinner, please forgive me. Lord Jesus is just and faithful to forgive each one of us. First book of John chapter 1 verse 7. The blood of Jesus Christ of Nazareth cleanses us from all sins. When you say, Lord Jesus, I am sorry for what all I have done, please forgive me. When you return to Lord Jesus, when you repent for your sins, when you humble yourself in the sight of Lord Jesus, what happens? There will be a miracle. There will be power of God. There will be grace of God. There will be blessing of God in your life. There is a reason for us to rejoice. There is a reason for us to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus. Number one reason, Lord Jesus won the battle. Reason number two, Lord Jesus is a risen Savior. He is no more in the graveyard. People in this world were searching for the dead body. Many women, 2019 years ago, had gone to the tomb in Israel to apply the perfumes to the dead body. But the angels had come to tell them that He is not there. He is risen. Praise be to Jesus. In the book of John, the Gospel, chapter 14, verse 19. Because Jesus lays, we shall lay. Praise be to Jesus. There is a reason for us to celebrate. Lord Jesus loves you, dear chosen children of God. It doesn't matter where you live. It doesn't matter who you are. It doesn't matter. Where do you come from? It doesn't matter. What is your background? It doesn't matter. What is the problem that you are facing? It doesn't matter. What is the sickness in this world? It doesn't matter. Whole world is locked down. But you are free in Jesus. In the book of John, the Gospel, chapter 8, verse 32. When you know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Praise be to Jesus. Spirit of the Lord is going to help you and I to receive the grace of God. Spirit of the Lord is going to help you and I to receive the love of God. Spirit of the Lord is going to help you and I to receive the blessings of God in our lives. Because Jesus lives, you and I shall live. So we need to rejoice every day, in every walk of our lives. Every minute, we have a breath of God. We have the gift of Holy Spirit. Greater is He that is in us than the one who is in this world. What is there in this world? Sickness is there in this world. Fears are there in this world. There is no peace in this world. Death is there in this world. The reason for fear, the reason for sickness, the reason for death, the reason for destruction is sin. Sin separated man from the presence of God. Sin separated man from the power of God. Sin separated man from the garment of righteousness. Sin separated man from the garment of salvation. Thanks be to Father for His love that He had shown to the mankind. In the book of Romans chapter 5, verses 8-9 reveals the truth to the mankind, dear chosen children of God. When we were yet sinners, Christ Jesus died for you and I on the cross of Calvary. Because He loves us so much. He is alive. So there is a reason for us to rejoice in the Lord. There's a reason for us to celebrate the resurrection power of Lord Jesus Christ. Because Jesus lives, you and I shall live. Be a chosen children of God. Lord Jesus loves you. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, so He gave His only begotten Son. Whosoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have a lasting life. You will not perish. Sickness will not destroy you. Problems in this world will not destroy you. Nothing can disturb your spirit. Nobody can touch your spirit. Your spirit and my spirit are sealed with the power of the Holy Spirit. In the book of Ephesians chapter 1, verse 13, we are sealed, our spirits are sealed with the power of the Holy Spirit. Spirit of the Lord dwells in us, dear chosen children of God. So why do you worry? Why are you afraid? Do not be afraid of anything in this world. In the book of John, the Gospel, Lord Jesus says, in my Father's house there are many mansions. If not so, I will go and prepare a place for you. And I'll come back and I'll take you to be with me where I am. Praise be to Jesus. Lord Jesus is coming again into this world, dear chosen children of God. He's going to come again to give us a reward for what we have done for the kingdom of God. What we have done to win the souls for His kingdom. Lord Jesus loves you so much. Why do we need to celebrate? Reason number one, Lord Jesus won the battle on the cross. Reason number two, Lord Jesus is risen Savior of the whole world. Reason number three, Lord Jesus loves us. Reason number four, He forgives us. Dear chosen children of God, Lord Jesus has authority to make sinner holy through His blood. The blood of Jesus cleanses us from all sins. In the book of Hebrews chapter 8 verse 12, I will not remember your sins anymore. Our God, our Lord Jesus is a loving God. He's a compassionate God. His heart is full of love, full of compassion, full of justice. Praise be to Jesus. He knows what you are, where you are. The physical pain, mental pain, spiritual pain, agony that you are going through. In the book of Hebrews chapter 2 verse 18, Lord Jesus went through the pain and the suffering to understand you and I and to help us. Praise be to Jesus. In the book of Hebrews chapter 4 verse 16, come to the throne of grace to receive the help in the time of trouble. Praise be to Jesus. Dear chosen children of God, Lord Jesus loves you. He forgives you and I. Come to the throne of grace with all of your heart. Take the help of the Holy Spirit. Spirit of the Lord is going to help you and I in every walk of our lives, dear chosen children of God. Lord Jesus has a great plan for you and for your family. Do not be afraid. Do not worry about anything in life. In the book of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 5 and 6, Spirit of the Lord says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Praise be to Jesus. In the book of Matthew chapter 28 verse 18, I have all the authority in heaven and on the earth. Nothing shall harm you, dear chosen children of God. I am with you till the end, Lord Jesus says. Go in peace. There is peace in Jesus. The name of Lord Jesus Christ is Prince of Peace. In the book of Isaiah chapter 57 verse 21, there is no peace in this world, but there is peace in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Praise be to Jesus. That our Lord, our God, our Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, did not give us a spirit of fear. But why are you afraid? Lord says, I did not give you a spirit of fear. I gave you power, love and sound mind. When you receive the revelation from the throne of grace, when you take the help of the Holy Spirit, you'll be bold like lion. In the book of Proverbs chapter 28 verse 1, the righteous will be bold like lion. In the midst of the problem, in the midst of the sickness, in the midst of the lockdown, the righteous will say, I'm bold. The righteous will be bold like lion. Jesus Christ of Nazareth is coming again to give us the reward. In the book of Matthew chapter 16 verse 27, dear chosen children of God, Lord Jesus is going to come again very soon. When he comes in the midst of the clouds with the holy angel, when the holy angel Michael blows the trumpet, and the heavenly host will join with Lord Jesus. And then what happens? Church will be raptured. The chosen saints and servants of God will be raptured. Be ready for the soon coming of Lord Jesus. Say after me, Maranatha. Lord Jesus, come soon. He is coming again to give us a reward. This is not the end. What you and I need to do? Go and preach the gospel. Declare the love of Christ. Declare to the whole world, Lord Jesus is the risen Savior. Praise be to Jesus for his love, for his grace, and for the gift of salvation. Dear children of God, let us agree with the word of God. Let us agree with the word of prophecies. Let us agree with the Holy Spirit. And let us bless the whole world with the word of prayer. Let us pray. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for helping us to rejoice in Jesus Christ of Nazareth. There is a reason for us to rejoice. There is a reason for us to celebrate, because Lord Jesus won the battle on the cross. We have a reason to celebrate because Lord Jesus is the risen Savior. We have a reason to celebrate because Lord Jesus loves us. We have a reason to celebrate because Lord Jesus forgives us. We have a reason to celebrate because Lord Jesus has taken our penalty, our punishment, our wickedness, our sickness, our sin on the cross of Calvary. Therefore, we celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for revealing the truth to the mankind. We love you, we bless you. We stand for your chosen children, O Father. We stand on behalf of the churches. We stand on behalf of your chosen generation. We ask for mercy. We ask for mercy, O Lord. Have mercy on us, O Lord. We ask forgiveness for our sins, for our forefathers' sins. For the sins of the Jewish people, we ask forgiveness. For the sins of the saints and the servants of God, we ask forgiveness. For the sins of the nations, O Father God, have mercy on us. You are a merciful God. You are a loving God. Lord Jesus, we thank you for your precious blood that you shed on the cross of Calvary. We thank you for forgiving each one of our sins. We thank you for cleansing each one of our sins through your precious blood. We thank you for the eternal life. We thank you for the holiness, righteousness through your precious blood. We love you. We bless your holy name. We bring nations in your presence, O Father. And we pray for the healing of the nations in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Father God, we thank you for the president, prime minister, government authorities and the people of this nation. We bless them with the word of salvation. We thank you for the police department. We thank you for the medical staff. We thank you for the municipality. We thank you for all the volunteers. We thank you for everyone who are involved to look after the people in every country, O Father. We bless them with the word of salvation. We bring unbelievers in every country in your presence, O Father God. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for helping the unbelievers to receive the grace, to receive the revelation that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is the Son of God. Jesus died on the cross and rose again after 3 days. We thank you for the revelation. We thank you for helping them to receive the gift of salvation. We bless nations with the word of salvation. We bring all the sick in every country. We command the sickness to get out in the name of Jesus. We declare you are free in Jesus. We declare you are free in Jesus. Thank you, dear Holy Spirit of God, for helping your children to receive the grace, to receive the healing, to receive the salvation. By the wounds of Lord Jesus, you are healed. Every fear, every doubt, every plan of Satan be broken in the name of Jesus. We are under the blood of Jesus. Jesus is the Lord of our lives. We bless Jerusalem, we bless Jewish people in every country with peace, with protection, with the gift of salvation. We thank you for your Lordship. We thank you for your love. Thank you for preparing our hearts to receive the grace, to receive the love of God, and to celebrate the victory of Lord Jesus Christ in every walk of our lives. We love you, we bless you. Thank you for your children who are joining us, O Father, from every country. We thank you for every saint and every servant of God. We thank you for all the churches. We bless them in the name of Jesus. Thank you for helping us to rejoice in Lord Jesus Christ. We love you, we bless you. Thank you, Jesus, for your Lordship. Thank you for the victory. We are more than conquerors through Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thanks be to God who gives us the victory through Lord Jesus. We love you, we bless you. We receive healing, we receive freedom, we receive boldness, we receive blessings of God in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We love you, we bless you. Thank you for sending us with your presence, with your love, with your power, with your blessings. In Jesus' name we agree and we pray. Amen. Shalom.